Hi all and welcome at my channel. On this video here I just wanna show you the BIOS programmer. This is a mini programmer like you can see for a lot, or we can say for some BIOS chips from motherboards, from computers. And with this one you can really program and we can say flash your BIOS chips from the most we can say motherboards. So we are talking here about the mini programmer CH341A. The thing is, you can find a lot on eBay about these things here. You can find them with a green color, yellow color, blue color and whatever, so that's why I will call this one here the black edition. On this video I will show you how you can be able to install the USB driver, because a lot of people have the problem that they cannot install the USB driver, and as long you will not install the USB driver you can't use this machine. For the newcomers on my channel, sorry for my English, but the most we can say the most important is that you can understand something. Yeah, I will begin to tell you how you can fix the first problem. When this one here is in the package, this jumper, I don't know why, but this jumper was sitting exactly here. Wait. It was sitting here. And that's why I was not able to install the USB drivers. If you believe or not, guys, if you have the same problem, the first thing that you shall do is to take this jumper and put him on this side. Now I will just demonstrate you that this is really not working when this jumper is really sitting here or here or here. It doesn't matter, but my was sitting here. You can also put the jumper here or whatever. It will not work, really not. You will not be able to install your drivers. You will just fix this problem if you put this jumper all on the right side. Okay? So, for that test now, I will need to show you now on the computer. Alright, now I will just start the program. And like you can see here down, the device is not connected. Okay, it's written here, not connected. I will zoom soon, wait. And I will also try to show my notebook, so that you can see that I will put and connect this now inside my USB port. So let's just focus one time, but it's okay I think. So like I told, we have now the jumper, like I told, on the right side. Yeah, the focus is now bad a bit because it's so dark here, but I try it. Yeah, but you can see the jumper is on the right side, and now I will just connect this to my computer. And here we go, you can see now the device state is connected. Okay, so that means that all is working great and the we can say BIOS programmer is, or we can say is ready to work. Okay, so I will now just disconnect it again, and now you can see here again device state not connected. I will now just move the jumper. Let me focus this a bit. Alright, I will now just move the jumper somewhere. It doesn't matter. I can put it for you here also, okay? And now we will do the same test again, and I will just connect it. And like you can hear, it makes da-da-da, okay? Again for you guys, I will make it a bit louder. Okay, it's not working. Let me see how loud this is. It's okay, it's on maximum. Alright, I will now put the jumper, like I told, somewhere else. Let's say about here, like it was on the package. Okay? It was like that in the package. Let me zoom again, or focus for you guys. And you can see it's not working. Okay? So like I told, I have test all the night. What can be the problem? Because you can't find something on the internet. I have found one video also on YouTube, but yeah, this guy has also not tell about this problem because maybe he doesn't know. I will now just put the jumper back to the site where it should be if you got the Black Edition one. Now focus back on the computer and again for you guys. Okay, it's working just perfect. Alright, now you can see the symbol is down here and we have connected chip on the top of this programmer. I will now put the camera back again for you guys here. So, wait. And also, take care now. Wait, let me focus. And now you can see it's working. And here also, you can see device is connected. And then we go here. I will move just this a bit down, otherwise it will reflect. And I will not be able to record this very well. So now it's connected. And as while it's connected, you can also do a test. And you can go here and tell him to detect it. So when you detect it, it should be written the manufacturer, memory name and all the rest. If this is all like that, then you will be able to program now your BIOS. The other thing that I wanted to show you also quickly is if you got the problem that this program here is all on Japanese or Chinese or Korean or whatever, you can fix this over here. So this folder is not there, but normally this English text here is not here. This English text is normally just here and you have also no folder here. Okay, normally you don't have this folder. So when you start this program now, your program will be Japanese or Chinese or whatever. You can see that now. You will not be able to understand nothing. So that's why if you want to have this in English, you go here on your folder, you make here a new folder and the name must be languages. Like that. Here you put now the English text inside the folder from languages, okay? Just now if you start the program again, it will be in English like you can see, alright? So I hope I have forget nothing. Yes, if you are using it for the first time, the first thing that you should do is install this driver here. Okay, this driver, but be sure that your jumper is connected right, otherwise it will not work. Really not work. Yeah, if this driver is not working, then you can try the driver on 64 bits. But this one here should normally work on all operation systems on 32 bits, like also on 64 bits. It works for me. It was working for me, this driver here. I am now running Windows 7 64 bits, so this should work also for you guys. If you want now to flash, we can say a BIOS chip, you should get your BIOS file from, I don't know if it's BIOS from Asus or BIOS from I don't know, Gigabyte or BIOS from MSI or BIOS from EVGA or whatever. You should download the BIOS that you want and then you just need the BIOS file, and mostly it's .bin file like you can see. So if you want, I will show you just this also, because then I will finish this video. If you now want to flash a clean BIOS to your BIOS chip, you should, I will just wait. Yeah, I will just put the BIOS to the size here. So if you want to reflash your destroyed BIOS, so if you had here a destroyed BIOS, you can now flash a new one. Okay, I will now show you how to do that, but this is really simple. So for first, you go again to the folder here and you start this tool. So then you just plug in your USB BIOS programmer, and then you can, if you don't have here this symbol here, detect, okay, it can also be that this symbol is not here. So you have chip search and this all here, but maybe you will have not the option to detect your chip, and this is just when this is set it wrong here, you see, because you have, this is now the wrong chip. It's not this chip, you will need this kind of chips, okay? And then you can click to detect it, and if the name and all is written, then it's good. When it's here written unknown and unknown and unknown, then that means that the chip is not plugged in on the right side. All right, if you have now detected your chip, you can try to read it. And now you can see it's working. Wait here. And now you got here your BIOS. So now you called save this BIOS. If you want to save your BIOS chip, you can now just go here and save this BIOS chip anywhere to the desktop or whatever. Just write here the file name, and this will be saved with a bin file. If you want now to install or flash a new BIOS, you should now just erase all the BIOS chip. This is the best way you can do. I have tested this already and it worked for me. So you go here and you just erase all. And then you just press OK. And now, just to test, you can read it again. And then it should be everywhere FFFFFF. Okay? Let's just read it again. So, you can see something. I'll zoom back. So, and now you can see it's everywhere FFFFFFFFF. And that's mean that your chip is really now, we can say, deleted. It was now erased, really deleted. This is the best way to install a new BIOS or to flash a new BIOS. Alright, now you can go here and open your BIOS. You tell him now where have you put your BIOS file, and I have my BIOS file here on the desktop, and this is this one here. Okay, now just click it 2 times. And then you can just go over here and say program it. You have see that all these F's are now with other signs because he has detect now my BIOS. Okay. Again for you guys, let's just read again the BIOS chip, the existing BIOS chip that it's already now connected, and it will come all about F because this BIOS chip already on the USB programmer is erased, we can say deleted. And then when you open a new BIOS, a new BIOS, you will see now that all here is just not the same. So you can be sure that you have the right BIOS. And then you just go over here and you click program. Okay, so now it's flashing this BIOS file to the USB programmer. Like you can see, it's also here getting green. That means it's writing, it's flashing, and now it's finished. Okay, red means power, green means it's working or flashing. So sorry because my LEDs, LED lights from the smartphone is just going off because my battery goes off. And yeah, this is also the finish of the video. I think I have show you all that you should know. You can now go just for the test if this BIOS is really flashed. Just if you want to be sure if this BIOS is really flashed, you can go again to read. So it will read again the BIOS on this chip. And yeah, it looks all like the BIOS before too. And now you can be sure that this is all just perfect. You can also hear and you can verify it. And then it will check also if all is really great or not. But this should be just perfect. Yeah, chip and buffer are the same. So that means this is all just perfect. Okay, guys. Now you can just disconnect it. You can close the tool and then you can use now, we can say, your new flashed BIOS chip. Sorry for the lights because my battery is just going off now. I have just here a bad light now because it's dark here already and it's late now here. I hope I could explain you all. At last, I must say this stuff here is really great. I have saved now my motherboard. And I'm very happy because you don't need to buy always a BIOS chip because it costs you also about 10 or 15 euros with shipment. So you can just take your BIOS chip from your motherboard and you can flash it. Just easy go with this stuff here. You can flash a lot chips with a lot manufacturers. And this was a chip now from Winbound. Yeah. Okay, guys. If you have some questions, I will try to respond to you on my YouTube channel. For now, I wish you the best. Peace, like always. If you like it, thumbs up. If you don't have subscribed, then subscribe here somewhere. And yeah, I wish you the best. Have a nice time. And see you in the place to be. Bye-bye.